Hi dear students, welcome to business studies class. So it is the third video of our sixth chapter, that is the staffing. So in this video I am going to explaining about the staffing process. So very interesting part, and according to exam point of view, otherwise you can take as a general knowledge. This content it is a very important, because in future maybe you are going to face such interviews. Okay, so you have to know what are the steps it is going to be carried out within the organization while they are doing a staffing. Okay, so without wasting a time, let's start. So basically there are total 8 step of staffing. See, staffing, it is not only the limited up to the picking a right person for the right job. It is not ending at that point. So complete take care of that employees, it is include within the staffing process also. So in last video I explained about the human resource management. So overall process of human resource management, it include within the staffing process. Okay, so it is not only up to the limited up to the only picking a right person for the right job. That much it is not enough. After that, the that employer means, otherwise you can call the organization, should give a training to that employees. They should give a proper compensation to that employees. So otherwise you can call performance appraisal. So everything it is included within the staffing. So it is not limited up to picking a right person up to that. Okay, so basically there are total 8 steps while doing a staffing process. So first step, it is estimating manpower requirement. So in this figure you are getting that. So first one is estimating manpower requirement, second one recruitment, third one selection, fourth one placement and orientation, fifth one training and development, sixth one performance appraisal, next promotion and career planning, and last step it is a compensation. Okay, so let's start with the one by one. So first step, it is a estimation of required manpower. So what is the meaning of it? The number of person and kind of persons required in the organization must be estimated. Means what? Suppose within the organization everything it is done, now we want a staffs, otherwise we want a employees for the organization. So what is the first step for that? You should estimate how many persons are, otherwise how many employees are required for the organization. Means you should just calculate how many people should be required to carry out whole work of that organization, otherwise whole work of that company. You should calculate that, means how many persons are required. Second thing, you should calculate that how many person, means what kind of person, means what qualification, what experience, what kind of qualification they should have. So what kind of experience they should have. So you should calculate that thing also at initial stage only. That is the first step of any staffing process. Means what? How many people are required to carry out the organizational work, and what kind, means what kind of education they should have. Means within the same organization, some different departments are there, no? So according to departments, how many people, otherwise what qualification of that people required for the planning department, what kind of people required for the production department, what kind of people required for finance department. Means according to the department, the kind qualification of people are going to be different. According to department, number of people are also required differently. So initial or first step of staffing, you should calculate how many people are required to perform that organizational work. Second thing, which kind of, means which qualification they should require to carry out that work. So that is the first step. So there are two steps. Analysis helps in the determining whether there is any overstaffing or understaffing in the organization. Based on this, the staffing process is carried out. So before you going for the, if your organization it is new, you should obviously go for the staffing process. But within means already that organization is exist, and some of staff they are left from that organization. So you should calculate that first thing. Overstaffing means what? How many we required, and rather than that, we have more staffs within our organization. So that is the overstaffing. Means we are necessary only 5 people to carry out the our organizational work, but within our organization we employed 10 people. So that is the overstaffing. Means 5 people are extra there. So that is not necessary for organization. That is the overstaffing. And another thing, that is the understaffing, means what? For that organization, 10 people are required, but we have only five peoples. So another five peoples we have to employ. We have to take a new employment of five people. Okay, so that is the understaffing. Means at initial stage only you should calculate how many peoples are required, which kind of peoples are required. You should find there is a overstaffing or understaffing things are there. If the overstaffing things are there, means rather than the requirement of people, we have extra employees at our organization. So we have to go for the removal of some of that employees, means who are not performing well, whose performance appraisal it is not good, whose feedback it is not good. We should give them transfer. Otherwise, we should remove that people from that organization. That is the solution for the overstaffing and understaffing. If the understaffing it is there, then we should go for the recruitment of new employees. That is the thing there. Okay, so for example, in a situation of understaffing, additional person would be the required, and on the other hand, in situation of overstaffing, some existing personnel may be removed. That is only I took. So here work analysis, workload analysis and workforce analysis are there. So workload means how much works are there. So number and types of human resources necessary for the performance of various job. Workload means how many number and type of human resources, peoples are required to perform the different job. And workforce analysis means number and type of available in the organization. So how many workload it is there, and how many workforce are there, we should analyze this thing. If the understaffs are there, we should go for the recruitment. If the overstaffs are there, we should remove them. Otherwise, we should give a transfer of that employees. If the optimal means we are required five people, and within our organization already five people are there. So that is the optimal staff. No need to go for the removal also. No need to go for recruitment also. So I hope you got this first step. Okay, so that is you should analysis how many peoples are required for our organization, and second thing, which kind of peoples are required for our organization. So that is the clear thing within the estimating of manpower. So second step is recruitment. Recruitment means what? Refers to the searching for prospective candidates and convincing them to apply for a job vacancies. Means what? Recruitment. Suppose if overstaffs are there, there is no need to go for the recruitment, because more than necessary we have the extra staff, so we have to remove them from organization. If the understaffing things are there, we should go for the recruitment. Means what? We should go and we were searching a people, which kind of people are required for our organization. So we are giving the advertisement on through net, otherwise through a newspaper, otherwise through a pamphlet. So we are giving that advertisement. That is the recruitment. Okay, so for the recruitment means within that everything it is included. So how many vacancies are there, so which kind of means which qualification we are required for our organization, so which kind of experience they should have, means everything, what is the necessary thing about that candidate we are mentioning within the recruitment. So that is the second step within the staffing process. So for the recruitment process, there are two types. One is internal source and another one is external source. Internal source means what? One is transfer and promotion. And external source means what? We should give the advertisement. Otherwise, we should go to the placement agencies. Otherwise, you can call the we should visit some colleges. If we want a freshers, we should visit some colleges. We should take the interview from that colleges, and we can complete the recruitment process. So within two sources are there, one is internal and one is external source. So this bit is coming soon, so I will explain within that. In shortly I will explain here. So internal source means what? How many peoples are within our organization? No, we have to give a transfer, otherwise promotion to that people only. So you should take example here. We need a principal for our college. Okay, is it right? So what we have to do? There are two sources, otherwise there are two solutions. One, we should recruit from outside, means we should give the recruitment. Such kind of people are required for this organization. If anybody interested, please do apply for it. Okay, so we can recruit from external source, means from external. And second thing, we should give a promotion from who are existing. So how many staffs are existing? No, from that only we should give a promotion as a principal post. So that is the internal source, means transfer or promotion, that is the internal source. And external source means what? We should take the recruitment from outside. So I hope you got the thing, what is the recruitment. And with this process, a pool of prospective candidates is created, which then form the basis of further selection suitable candidate. So how many, suppose within the internal source only we are occupied the everything, so there is no need to move further, but we want the people from external source, so then we have to go for the external source, we have to visit to colleges, otherwise we have to visit to placement agencies, we should give the advertisement, and how many peoples are applying for that job. So we have to go through the resume, or you can call it the biodata. We have to check each and every biodata of employees, and according to that we are going for the short list of that candidates. So you can call, we are go for the short list of candidates, because for one single job there are n number of applications are there, so we have to go through each biodata of each individual person, then we have to go for the short list of candidate. So that is the next is third step, that is the selection. So what is the selection means what? The procedure comprises a series of tests and interviews. So means what? Within the selection process, after giving the application form, within the recruitment process, how many candidates or how many peoples are interested for that job? All they are submitted their application form along with their biodata. So next step, what is there? We have to go for the shortlist of biodata according to our requirements. Then we have to go for the selection of employees, because one single job, there are n number of applications are there, and which person, otherwise which candidate it is suitable, we have to choose according to that. So within the selection process, there are series of tests are there. Means we are not going to directly select that employee, otherwise we are not going to directly select that candidate. So candidate who are able to successfully clear the process are selected, while the others are rejected. So within the selection process, what kind of steps are there? First, we have to check the aptitude, otherwise we have to check the knowledge of that people, then personality test, medical test, a fitness test, means every that candidate should pass each and every test. It is that test, it is organized by organization. Okay, so if the candidate it passed all the tests successfully, so that is the process for selection, and who are not passed all the tests, so they are rejected from the selection process. So emphasis must be laid on rigorous selection process. So the meaning of rigorous, it is very carefully, means what is the selection process, it is no, it is stressed very carefully process, such that the most competent candidate gets selected, and thereby the working efficiency of the organization improves. So why the selection step, it is a very important, because if we do any negligence in a selection process, we are going to get a wrong person for our organization. If we are getting a wrong person for our organization, that is loss to our organization, because if it is a wrong person, it is not able to do the work, then what is the use of it? So we have to do the correct checking of that candidates. We have to check correctly. We have to select a person or candidate correctly. That is a very important step within the selection process. So because if the person it is right, so it obviously the efficiency, otherwise the performance of that candidate will be the good for the organization. So selection process, it is a very important. Next, a person who successfully undergoes the interview and passes the test given the employment contract. If the candidate who passed all the tests clearly, he passed all the tests successfully, for that candidate we are going to give a appointment later. So in this video it is enough. So what is the selection process, I will continue in another video. So watch the second video also. Thank you. Hi dear students, welcome to business studies class. So in this video, what is the staffing process, I am going to continue in this video. So in last video, I explained about only three steps of staffing process. So that is the first one, I explained about the estimating. estimation of required manpower means how many peoples are required and which kind of peoples are required. That is the first step. Second step, that is the recruitment, means what if peoples are required, so we should give the advertisement. Otherwise, we should go for which kind of people required, what should be the qualification, what should be the experience, everything we should mention within the advertisement. So that is the process of recruitment. And if you are giving a recruitment, how many candidates are interested, they are applying their application for that job along with their per data. Next step, that is the third step, that is the selection. So within selection, so organization should go through the biodata of all the candidates and which are suitable. We are going to make a shortlist of that candidate and we are going to take a test of all that candidates and who are passed successfully all the test of that candidate. So which kind of test are going to taken within the selection process, that is coming in next video. Okay, so within that steps also I will going to explain that in detail. Okay, so within the selection process, what kind of tests are taken? No, so if the employees are passed that all tests successfully, the organization is giving a appointment letter to that candidate. So in last video I explained up to this selection process and what are the next or fourth steps I am explaining from this video. So fourth step, it is a placement and orientation. So placement refers to occupying of the post by the candidate for which he has been selected. Means what, in last step, that is within the selection, we are selected the candidate which is a suitable for the organization and we are giving an appointment letter. And within the placement means what, that candidate, it is start to join our organization, means he is going to take or he is going to occupy his place within that organization. So he is going to taking a charge of that place. Okay, so that is the placement. And orientation means what? Orientation refers to the introduction of the selected new employee to his or her superiors, subordinate and colleagues and familiarizing him or her with the rules and policies of the organization. So orientation, the orientation programs are within the organization. There will be the special orientation program, or in colleges also, some colleges also they are arranging the orientation program. So you can call the freshers party for it. Within that, what is going to be happen? So who are new employees is there, no? So we are going to give the introduction of that new employees to existing employees, means who are coming a new person in our organization. So we are giving the introduction of to that employees with other employees, otherwise with colleagues who are head to that person, with the superior, with subordinates, with boss, means we are giving the introduction and we are making a familiar that person with that organization, means we are giving giving the information about each other who are working within that organization. That is the orientation program. Otherwise, we are telling what are the rules of this organization, what are the policies of organization, means everything. So who are ahead, who are your juniors, who are your seniors. So we are giving the introduction of all employees who are related with that person, means we are making a familiar that person with our organization. So that is the orientation. So next step, it is the training and development. So training, it is concerned with upgradation of the knowledge and skills of employees so that their ability to perform can be enhanced. So what is the training means what? Already you know what is the training. So giving upgradation of the knowledge and skills of employees so that their ability of performance can be enhanced. Suppose that person need to take a more knowledge, otherwise he is not able to do some work, we have to give a support by giving a training. So training may be there outside, there are types of trainings are also there. The training, it is given by the outside agencies also, otherwise within the organization also, by who are a superior, otherwise who are a supervisor. The supervisor is always giving a training to their employees. So that is the training. So why training, it is important to upgrade our knowledge, means we should gain the more knowledge from training and we can improve the skills. So for that training it is important. And next, that is the development. So what is the development? So development is the process of learning and growth सो दैट स्किल्स एंड कॉम्पिटेंसीज, कॉम्पिटेंसीज मीन्स एबिलिटी, एबिलिटी कैन बी एक्वायर्ड टू डू हायर लेवल्स ऑफ जॉब. सो डेवलपमेंट मीन्स वॉट, इट इज़ अ डेवलपमेंट ऑफ दैट एम्प्लॉयज. सो ही कैन लर्न, ही और शी कैन लर्न द न्यू थिंग्स, दे कैन इम्प्रूव देयर स्किल्स, अदरवाइज दे कैन इम्प्रूव देयर एबिलिटीज, एंड दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द हायर लेवल ऑफ जॉब्स. सो इफ दैट एम्प्लॉयज इज परफॉर्मिंग गुड थिंग विद इन दैट ऑर्गनाइजेशन, सो ऑब्वियसली ही नीड ऑफ हायर जॉब पोजिशन, अदरवाइज यू कैन कॉल द इंक्रीमेंट. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट स्टेप दैट इज अ परफॉर्मेंस अप्राइजल. द लास्ट ओनली आई टोल्ड विद इन द डेवलपमेंट, डेवलपमेंट मीन्स वॉट, वी शुड गो गिव अ प्रमोशन टू दैट एम्प्लॉयज. सो वॉट इज अ प्रमोशन टाइम, दैट इज द परफॉर्मेंस अप्राइजल. सो वॉट इज अ परफॉर्मेंस अप्राइजल मीन्स वॉट, इट रेफर्स टू द इवेल्युएशन ऑफ परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ एम्प्लॉयज अगेंस्ट सम स्टैंडर्ड. मीन्स वॉट, मोस्टली द विद इन द ऑर्गनाइजेशन आफ्टर द कंप्लीशन ऑफ वन ईयर फ्रॉम जॉइनिंग, वी हैव टू गिव द परफॉर्मेंस अप्राइजल टू अवर हेड. मीन्स वॉट, सो इफ आफ्टर जॉइनिंग विद इन अ वन ईयर वॉट काइंड ऑफ वर्क दैट एम्प्लॉयज डिड, सो एवरीथिंग रिकॉर्डेड, अदरवाइज इट कैन बी मेजर्ड. मीन्स ड्यू टू दैट पर्सन विच थिंग्स आर बेनिफिशियल फॉर द ऑर्गनाइजेशन, वी शुड रिकॉर्ड द थिंग्स. सो दैट इज द परफॉर्मेंस अप्राइजल. मीन्स वॉट, वॉट काइंड ऑफ परफॉर्मेंस दैट एम्प्लॉयज डिड विद इन द ऑर्गनाइजेशन विद इन द वन ईयर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम, सो दैट इज द परफॉर्मेंस अप्राइजल. एंड मोस्टली दैट परफॉर्मेंस अप्राइजल इट इज साइंड बाय सीनियर ऑफ दैट एम्प्लॉयज, अदरवाइज इट इज साइंड बाय सुपेरियर ऑफ दैट एम्प्लॉयज, अदरवाइज सुपेरियर शुड गिव अ फीडबैक अबाउट दैट पर्सन फॉर द इंक्रीमेंट पर्पज. सो परफॉर्मेंस अप्राइजल इट इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट बीट फॉर द इंक्रीमेंट पर्पज. मीन्स स्टैंडर्ड्स आर इन्फॉर्म टू एम्प्लॉयज वेल इन एडवांस, सो सुपेरियर प्रिपेयर अ फीडबैक रिपोर्ट बेस्ड ऑन द परफॉर्मेंस अप्राइजल. मीन्स वॉट, हु आर अ सीनियर, अदरवाइज हु आर हेड टू दैट एम्प्लॉयज, अदरवाइज हु आर हेड और सुपेरियर यू कैन कॉल, सो दैट सो इट इज़ द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ दैट सुपेरियर, दे शुड गिव द फीडबैक अबाउट दैट पर्सन. मीन्स सपोज टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ माइन ओनली, सो हु आर हेड टू मी, सो दे शुड गिव द फीडबैक अबाउट माई सेल्फ फॉर द इंक्रीमेंट पर्पज, दैट इज द परफॉर्मेंस अप्राइजल. सो नेक्स्ट स्टेप दैट इज द प्रमोशन एंड करियर प्लानिंग. सो प्रमोशन रेफर्स टू द प्लेसमेंट ऑफ एन एम्प्लॉयज एट हायर जॉब पोजिशन विद द हायर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज, फैसिलिटीज, स्टेटस एंड पे. सो वॉट इज अ प्रमोशन? सो आफ्टर गिविंग द परफॉर्मेंस अप्राइजल मीन्स विद इन द परफॉर्मेंस अप्राइजल वॉट काइंड, वॉट थिंग्स आर इंक्लूडेड वन विद इन वन ईयर ऑफ पीरियड, विच काइंड ऑफ दैट वर्क दैट इज परफॉर्म बाय दैट कैंडिडेट. सो गुड थिंग, मोस्टली गुड थिंग, अदरवाइज इट इंक्लूड द बैड थिंग ऑल्सो नो डाउट विद इन दैट. सो बाय रेफरिंग द परफॉर्मेंस अप्राइजल, इफ ड्यू टू दैट पर्सन ऑर्गनाइजेशन गेट द बेनिफिट, देन ऑर्गनाइजेशन गोइंग टू थिंक अबाउट द प्रमोशन ऑफ दैट एम्प्लॉय. ओके, सो इफ द परफॉर्मेंस अप्राइजल इज गुड, ऑब्वियसली दैट कैंडिडेट इट इज गोइंग टू गेट द प्रमोशन, दैट इज अ हायर लेवल ऑफ जॉब पोजिशन. सो इफ द जॉब पोजिशन इज हायर लेवल, ऑब्वियसली द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी इट इज गोइंग टू बी इंक्रीजिंग, facility it is going to be increasing, status within the organization it is going to be increasing, and pay, that is the payment also going to be increasing. So after the performance appraisal there may be the chances of promotions. Next, career planning means what? Promotion is on the basis of feedback report of employee. So what is the feedback report of that person given by their seniors, otherwise given by their heads? So it depend upon that. Promotion is depend upon mostly on performance appraisal. So career planning, it may be for individually, otherwise it may be for organizationally, there may be the career planning. So next, that is the last step, that is the compensation. So compensation refers to the price paid for the job and includes pay, rewards and other incentives and indirect payments which are given to the employees. So compensation means basically in short salary, otherwise wages you can call. So what price we are paid, otherwise what kind of salary we are paying to that employees. So it includes pays, otherwise rewards means some certificates are there, otherwise other incentives. So within the compensation there are two kinds of incentives, one is financial incentives, other one is non-financial incentives. So always the payment in terms of money, that not the matter. Sometimes your good words, otherwise encouragement, it is also important to do the good performance. And sometimes giving a higher payment, that is also the encouragement for the good performance. So that is the incentives, that bit is also coming soon, okay. So payments which are given to the employees, so direct payments, that is in terms of wages. Wages means daily basis, daily salary what we are giving, that is the wages, salaries. Within that also salary depend upon time basis, and sometimes it is on performance basis also. Means salary, it depend upon time basis, means how many hours that employee is working within that organization. So salary is depend upon that also, and sometimes on performance. So rather than the time, what kind of performance is going to give for the organization, so sometimes payment is depend upon that also. And indirect payments means medical facility, means to that employee, otherwise the family member of that employee, the medical facility is given, otherwise insurance, otherwise you can call the provident fund, that is a PF or pensions you are giving, otherwise living facility and transport facility. So these are also indirect payments, so for that we can call the compensation. So I hope you got all 8 steps for the selection process. Suppose if you have any doubt, please comment below. And according to exam point of view, according to your general knowledge point of view, this bit is very important. Please do not neglect these things. So thank you so much. Bye bye. Take care.